Hey there, viewers. Having trouble picking up heavy objects? Do you find it hard to handle even light objects? Is it a sharp pain in your arm stopping you? In today's video, we're going to discuss radial tunnel syndrome in detail. What is it? What are the symptoms? What causes it? How is radial tunnel syndrome diagnosed? What are your treatment options? We're talking about all of these and more. What is radial tunnel syndrome? Radial tunnel syndrome is when you suffer pain at the top of your forearm and your hand. The reason for this condition is because of an injury on your radial nerve. Wondering what the radial nerve is? It's the one that begins in your neck and goes all the way back to your arm. This particular nerve is responsible for moving your triceps, which is the muscle present in your upper arm. The radial tunnel is the area between your elbow. The radial nerve comes through this tunnel and goes all the way to your wrist. The reason you feel pain is because of an injury to your radial nerve. This can happen for any number of reasons, whether you're pushing, pulling, or grabbing. You can also pinch the radial nerve while repeatedly using your hands and wrists. If your job requires you to continuously move your wrists, they can get overused and can cause radial tunnel syndrome. Do you play tennis or any other sport that requires you to use your hands and wrists? Have you ever had severe pain in your arm? Share your experiences with the Bestie community in the comments below. Symptoms of radial tunnel syndrome. The main sign of radial tunnel syndrome is pain and weakness you feel in your forearm. But there are many other symptoms you need to look out for. For instance, you might feel pain in the back of your hand or below your elbow. The pain will also get worse when you rotate your wrists or extend your fingers. Radial tunnel syndrome will have you feeling tenderness outside your elbow. Some may find it difficult to push or lift objects, even ones that are lighter in weight. Just extending your wrist is a task. I know this sounds pretty rough, but don't worry, you probably won't experience all these symptoms. The intensity of pain will vary from person to person. Some will only be mild, while others will be much more intense. Looking for answers on all the latest health and wellness news? Hit that subscribe button and join our millions of followers. Stay up to date on all of our great Bestie content. Diagnosis. Examination. The first step towards diagnosis is the examination from a professional. The doctor will ask you questions about your hobbies and day-to-day life. This is to get a better idea of what might be causing the problem. Physical resistance. Your doctor will also do a few physical tests to determine which specific actions are causing your pain. For instance, you could be asked to push using your arm or hand, but without bending the elbow. In another test, you would be asked to press your middle finger against a resisting object. If you feel pain through either of these tests, it's an indication that you have radial tunnel syndrome. Electromyography, or EMG. On some occasions, your doctor may give you an EMG test. This will seek out damage done to your muscles and nerves, including the radial nerve. An EMG study is done in two parts. First, the nerve conduction, and second, a needle EMG. When the nerve conduction study is being done, the medical professional will put electrodes on your skin and see how your radial nerve and tricep muscles are communicating with each other. For the needle EMG test, your doctor put electrodes in your arm muscle. These electrodes will show your doctor your muscle's electrical activity. After the EMG test, your doctor will diagnose you. It pretty much all comes down to whether or not your radial nerve has been damaged. Before we move ahead, here's another video you might like. Our body often gives us signs that there's something wrong. It's too bad that we often ignore them. Here's a video on 7 symptoms of dangerous diseases, often ignored by women. Treatment options. While this condition seems pretty bleak, there is hope. Radial tunnel syndrome is usually pretty treatable. Most people make a full recovery within 3 to 6 weeks. Where to start? In the beginning, your doctor will usually suggest something simple. Once they determine which activity is causing the pain in your radial nerve, you'll be asked not to do that particular activity for up to 6 weeks. They may also tell you to avoid certain stretches before exercise. As for work, professionals will suggest you take more breaks than usual, especially if your job requires you to be moving around. In most cases, lifting heavy objects will be out of the question. You may also be given over-the-counter pain relief like ibuprofen. In other cases, you would be asked to place your wrist or elbow in splints. The doctor may also ask you to undergo physical therapy to relieve whatever irritation your nerve may be experiencing. Next steps. If your pain is a lot more severe and can't be alleviated by the above steps, the next step would be a steroid injection. When given in the arm, the steroid injection will reduce whatever swelling is present in your muscle and bring down the pressure on your radial nerve. Your doctor's goal with the treatment is to make sure the pain does not return. You may be asked to continue wearing the splint even after the pain has died down. In extreme cases, you'll be asked to check in with your workplace to see if you can reduce some of your physical activity. If possible, they may even relieve you of some of your duties for the time being. Surgical treatment. In most cases, the treatment options above are enough to remove the symptoms of radial tunnel syndrome, but in rare cases, they don't work. With this scenario, the next step is surgery. When you get surgery in this area, your radial tunnel will be widened. This way, the radial nerve gets more space and there'll be less pressure on it. If you do undergo the radial tunnel surgery, it can take up to 8 weeks for you to recover. Once the surgery is done, you'll need to keep your arm wrapped. The first week post-surgery is all about small exercises, massaging, and stretching. After a period of about 6 weeks, your doctor will add exercises to your regimen so you can slowly get your strength back in your wrist and elbow. It goes without saying that you're not supposed to lift any heavy items. You'll also be told to avoid doing any activities that require you to bend your elbow. The doctor will tell you beforehand what activities you can safely take part in. If you make a full recovery, it's important for you to follow all the steps and instructions your doctor gives you. You may even have to make some lifestyle changes. You wouldn't want to get injured again. Even after surgery, the pain may stay around. Luckily, it will only be mild. The rest of your symptoms will improve. Physical therapy. The good news is several people with radial tunnel syndrome have found relief through physical therapy and exercise. You can try the wrist extension stretch to find relief from pain caused by radial tunnel syndrome. For this, you need to first straighten your arm and bend your wrist back. It's like you're signaling someone to stop. Now apply gentle pressure across the palm using your opposite hand. Pull the palm towards you until you feel a stretch on the inside of your forearm. Hold the position for 15 seconds. Repeat 5 times, then move to the other arm. Repeat throughout the day. There is another wrist stretch you can try. For this, you need to bend your elbow at the side of your body with your palm facing the ceiling. Use your opposite hand to hold your wrist and gently turn your forearm further into the palm up position until you feel a stretch. Hold the position for 15 seconds. Repeat 5 times and move to the other arm. Radial tunnel syndrome is very painful. So are all the other bone and cartilage related issues. Now, how about learning ways to strengthen your cartilage and ligaments? Or learn to build healthier bones? Here's what you need to know. Watch 5 ways to strengthen your knees, cartilage, and ligaments. You can also try our video on 11 ways for you to build healthier bones. Go ahead and click one, or better yet, watch both, and learn more about health and fitness. Do you struggle with pain in your forearm? Could it be radial tunnel syndrome? Let us know in the comments below.